say, what the hell, they're like.
But Chandan, do you find a little creepy that there are people out there with gobbledygook handles? We don't know who they are.
I have great difficulty because I'm not on Twitter, but I'm on Facebook, and constantly you get friend requests from people who have no clue who they are.
Yeah.
They should at least tell us.
Yeah.
You know that who they are. Why do they want to become a friend? I mean, I would like to know, because I don't want to be friends with somebody who, you know, kind of weirdo.
You don't know,
as you said. Yes,
you are apprehensive about that.
I'm saying, but one minor point.
Yeah, yeah.
You know the point Gursimran made about, you know, being fake and not fake.
Yeah.
Frankly, I don't think I've ever had a problem. Mm-hmm. I think I'm as genuine and as real in life, and I don't have to go on a virtual medium to be fake or not fake.
So you're saying there's something potentially dysfunctional also about how you relate to this media.
In fact, there is a complexity to it which we shouldn't miss. There is an enabling part to the technology in that there is the genuineness of the loneliness of the urban condition.
Yeah.
On the other hand, it reinforces that, because you get this false sense of community and friendship. So it reduces your social skills in a sense in real life. The typical image that you have is, you know, 3 or 4, 5, 6 young people sitting in a room. They've come to spend the evening together, and they're all on their mobile.
Very true. Yeah.
But they're not talking to each other. They can spend the whole evening without talking to each other.
Yeah. And their knowledge of the English language is going for a talk.
No.
But
they don't know how to spell.
I'll get you guys the mic. Amir, you wanted to come in there. That we all. I crossed the street now, looking at my BlackBerry. Mm. I mean, I'm crossing the road and I'm still not looking up. Have we become, in a sense, while meeting some other kind of needs, become prisoners of our phones?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. And you have a question? Yeah,
you know, now the social media has come to phones. Yeah.
So that's come to phone.
You know, it's if you have to have conversations, even if you have to have friendly conversations, you have to keep your cell phones off or out. Yeah. Otherwise, and this is, it's not just prisoners, it's weird, it's, you're getting wrapped up in one little tablet, small
you
little tablet.
You are a prisoner of that technology.
Yeah, absolutely.
Can I just get Nirupama Rao on the program and I'll come back to you? Nirupama Rao came on to Twitter as Foreign Secretary, now of course she's Ambassador of India in Washington. Nirupama, you were the first senior ranking official to actually break the formal protocol driven mindset of the MEA and come on, what drew you to it, what made you do it?
Well, the public diplomacy division of the Ministry of External Affairs has been utilizing social media tools and technologies for some time now. You must be aware of the Facebook account that we have, the fact that 50 of our missions have Facebook accounts today. We have many, many followers both on Facebook and on the Ministry's Twitter account. So even before I had set up my individual Twitter account as Foreign Secretary, there was a certain experience and a certain exposure that the Ministry had already to social media. And I looked upon this as a challenge in some respects, but also something that we could utilize, that I as Foreign Secretary could utilize effectively as a communication tool.
And Nirupama, one of the times and the phases that you actually really did use it effectively was during Libya and Egypt, when evacuations were happening and mass contacts were being made through this medium. Did you find that it really made your job easier at that point as Foreign Secretary?
Exactly that. I think in a time of crisis and in a time when lots of people were looking to the Ministry for answers, for information, just seeking to reach out to us and seeking reassurance from us, I felt that the use of this tool met some of that need.
Can I ask you, we've been discussing this here, that social media has its share of trolls and ideologues. People will hound you and abuse you if they feel that you're not on their side. And that must happen a lot to people in the public eye. How did you deal with that, Nirupama?
Well, it did take a little getting used to, but I realized that in this dimension and in this day and age, when on the internet and in social media, you have to be accustomed and be prepared to receive all kinds of messages. In a sense, I began to get attuned to it after some time, but I must confess it took some time to get used to.
Yeah, I think it takes us all a bit of time to get used to that. One last question. Government of India is famously conservative. Were eyebrows raised when you decided to come online?
Well, it is true that we have not been known to use these tools to any great extent, but I noticed that a number of government departments have now slowly started using social media to reach out to audiences across the country. And I don't believe there was any opposition to my using Twitter at all. And in fact, the effect that we were able to bring about through using Twitter during the Libya evacuation and during the evacuation of our people from the Gulf, I think proved to a lot of people that this was an effective and useful tool.
So interesting comment there. Thank you, Nirupama, about getting used to a kind of online stalking that sometimes can take place where people get fixated. They keep tweeting you, keep tweeting you. You had a comment.
No, I just wanted to, I personally look at the whole business of whether it's tweets or whether it's Facebook or, you know, I think human communication between each other, it's suffering, and it is much more than just kind of words coming in. You have to see the person, his voice, his inflection, how he makes, how he's talking to you, you know. The whole person concrete, that whole concreteness is going away. People I saw, we came to NDTV on one same vehicle, and I saw none of each, you know, people, 5-6 people were there. Nobody is talking to each other. Some of them are using phones. The same thing happens on bus stop. When we were children, we used to talk. They come to this bus stop standing as school children, and nobody's talking to each other. I think this is an important thing which we are losing today.
People are chatting. They are chatting sitting side by side.
Yes.
Why can't they talk? Half the time only I call them.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Next to each other.
So are we becoming dysfunctional? Gurshamran, are we becoming dysfunctional?
Well, first of all, I'd like to say it's very funny when people say that this relationship and this friendship that we have online is fake. It's easy for people who are not there to believe that it's fake. But for us who are there, we've seen blood donors come out of Twitter. We've seen when there are bomb blasts, people are opening up their homes on Twitter, asking anybody in the vicinity who's online to come and stay with them, to be aided by them. So I think this whole idea of it being fake is just superfluous. It's not true.
All right, I can see you have a rebuttal. I'll get you the mic later. Your comment.
Yeah, on political class not getting into Twitter, and there are very few of them. Is it that something you're wary of, a bilateral dialogue with the people? There are 100 million internet users in India, and there are 134 million television users. So please, don't underestimate.
Quick response.
No, quick response. Definitely, you have to take it seriously. But let me tell you, you see, most politicians, or even the government of India, Nirupama said, is a one-way street. This is used as a medium to disseminate information. You are not really communicating. And politicians, in that sense, will find it difficult to communicate because so many difficult questions are asked, which people are not ready
to answer. Do you think Shashi would have still got into trouble today? Or do you think the mindset has changed?
I think so. Yes, why? He would have gone into trouble.
He would have.
Why?
Mindsets haven't changed.
Why?
And I think there would be enough people who would be saying, who would say, even now, that no, this is too much.
Derek, quickly.
I think we're done with dear old Shashi Tharoor. Let's, I mean, you know, he's been, I think the danger here is that some of the politicians or the Lalit Modis of the world trying to do twit and run journalism.
Nice one.
Not a bad one.
Not a bad one.
But that is also dangerous. You know, but I think I agree with what you say. Politicians today, and that's why I said they don't follow anyone. They are doing too much of broadcast and less of listening. This is a great listening medium.
Okay, we've got to take a quick break. In the last comment, what does Twitter tell us about ourselves? We've heard some thoughts here. Last comment.